Hi, Polar Ridge, Mr. B here. Got a question for you. Name this tune. Do you know the name of that tune? Well, that tune is the topic of our lesson for today. It's called Somewhere Over the Rainbow, written by Harold Arlen and Yip Harburg in 1939 for the movie The Wizard of Oz, based on the book by L. Frank Baum, The Wonderful Wizard of Oz. And it's just terrific. Now, you know, you've got some time on your hands at home. You could take this lesson and use it as a jumping off point to read the book by L. Frank Baum. That'd be fantastic. But our music lesson today is on the song Somewhere Over the Rainbow. And it's going to be for K through 5 with all sorts of little jumping off points where everyone can participate, or we're just, this will be for just K through 2 or just 3 through 5. So I'll have my little recommendations in there, and that'll be wonderful. First, I want to tell you a little story about why I thought of this lesson. So I just started a new Facebook page for Polar Ridge Music. And part of that is you know, people join the page and you get to see what's on their newsfeed. And one of the moms, she posted something for her son, a kid that we all know, I'm sure. His name is Branson, great, great kid. And so this is what she posted. She said Branson was in the kitchen, and suddenly he stopped what he was doing. He put his hand over his heart and he just froze. And she didn't know what he was doing. And then she realized the song Somewhere Over the Rainbow was playing in the next room in the background, and he was listening very, very, very carefully and reverently, like respectfully to it. And when I saw that post on Facebook, I loved it, and I wrote a couple things just about how great that is. And then I thought to myself, you know what? It's not random that particular song made such an impact on him and then had an impact on me. Because I was thinking, do you know what rainbows represent? Rainbows represent hope. Rainbows represent promise for the future. Going all the way back to ancient stories and myths and things like that, it's always represented something positive for the future. Whether you're talking about leprechauns finding gold at the end of the rainbow or the story from Noah in ancient Hebraic text, these are really, really important symbols that mean something to us. And I think during, you know, this time where school is not where it normally is, we all need a little bit of hope. So this lesson is about Somewhere Over the Rainbow, but really it's a hope lesson for you guys. And I hope it gives you that hope. Because there's a lot to look forward to, and we're all going to get through this. So, on to the lesson. The very first thing that I want to do is I want to present the song to you. I'm going to sing it, and this will be a chance for everybody to sing along with me, or just listen, or when you play it back, sing along with me. I'll have the lyrics printed up on the portal that we have for school, for special area for music, and you can download those lyrics and maybe have them printed in front of you and sing along, and that'll be wonderful. So this is for everybody. K through 5 can sing along with this. And it starts off with this beautiful octave jump. Somewhere, which is very, very hopeful, by the way, rising above where it starts. That octave jump is not an accident. That's a beautiful, thoughtful composition technique. Anyway, the song.
Yeah.
hope you enjoyed that, and I hope you were singing along with me. Great, great, great American song. Beautiful, beautiful, timeless song. Remember, this was made in 1939, so that means that this thing has lasted for 80 years. Anything that lasts that long is lasting that long for a very good reason. It's a well-made song. It's beautiful. It's timeless. It speaks to something deep within each one of us. Hopes, dreams, the future, all of that. Now, here's an interesting thing. I thought it would be a cool lesson for everybody to also do a listening lesson where you compare two other performances of that song. What I just did was a very standard performance of it. There was nothing, you know, super stylized or different about it. But here is a performance by one of my favorite singers, Eva Cassidy. And I want you to listen to this performance of it. We're just going to play a tiny little bit, and you'll have the links to this performance on the music portal and in other places as well. But I'm just going to go there right now and listen to how Eva Cassidy does this song differently. You're going to be listening for what makes this performance special, what makes it different, and just a little bit. Good. I'm going to pause that right there. That's just a little taste test right there. She grows the song beautifully. It's magnificent where she goes with the song. Then I want you to compare it with this. This is by a Hawaiian man named Iz, which is short for Israel, and he's doing it on a very special instrument that I want you to, you know, think and guess what instrument it is. Said the links to these are going to be on the lesson plan that will be in the student portal on the music website. Now, this song was creatively recorded in their own style. It's like they thought to themselves, what does this song mean to me? And they put their own little twist on it. So here's assignment number one. There are going to be a couple different assignments here. This is for K2. I want you to begin thinking about what hope or promise means to you. You can write about that. You can write about that and keep it at home and share it with your family. You can write about that and share it with me. That would be phenomenal. If you have your parents email me what you think about hope, if you your parents connect with me on Facebook, you can also do it that way. And you know, they can write a comment underneath this video. I want to know from you what makes you hopeful, what makes you feel like everything's going to be all right. We're going through a bit of a tough time right now, But there definitely is a rainbow, and there is hope at the end of it all. Now, grades 3 through 5, I've got a little bit of a different thing for you guys. You guys are learning about comparing and contrasting things. You've got a double bubble map, and I mean, maybe, you know, some of the second graders, even the first graders maybe could get this. It would be cool to make a double bubble map that had on one side Eva Cassidy, somewhere over the rainbow. On the other side is somewhere over the rainbow. IZ is how he spells his name. And then all of the things that they have in common with the bubbles connecting on both sides. And then all of the things that those performances don't have in common. And I want you to think of things like the instrumentation, how they treat the melody, the way they sing it. Are there other instruments? And I want you to start thinking about that. Once again, you can connect with me in all of the ways that I mentioned before and share your work with me that way. And that would be a pretty amazing thing to do. Now, for 3 through 5, I wanna go into the song, Somewhere Over the Rainbow, and what it means. It's an interesting thing. It comes from The Wizard of Oz, which we've talked about universal plots, how many stories have plots that all over the world for thousands of years, people have been telling the same basic plot. And this is a very, very common plot called a journey and return story, which goes something like this. The main character starts at home. They get transported to a very strange new place, or the place around them changes in a very strange way. They're faced with lots of challenges. They rise to the challenge. They learn something. And then they return either back to normal or back to home, having learned something, having grown, having matured. This song comes from The Wizard of Oz, where Dorothy goes from home to Oz, strange land, faces challenges, comes home having learned something, that there's no place like home, which is a nice thing to learn. So here's my question for you. This song, which is connected to the journey and return story, what is it that you hope to learn from this strange experience we're in right now? Because folks, the world is not the same as it was just a month ago or 2 months ago. It's very, very different. We're gonna be fine, but there are things to learn along this journey. And so 3 through 5, I would challenge you to think about that. What can you learn from this time? What could you do to make the most of this time that's not kind of normally structured for you? Is it the kind of thing where you just, you know, waste it doing nothing? Or are there constructive things that you can do to make the best of your time? I would challenge you to do that. Now, another thing, I was talking to my buddy, Mr. Sword. He's an amazing art teacher. And we were talking about rainbows. And rainbows, of course, connect with art in a beautiful way because it's the whole color spectrum. Roy G. Biv, right? Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, violet. Roy G. Biv, all of those. Kind of interesting. I'm going to throw this in for free. There are 7 colors in the rainbow, and there are actually 7 different letter names on the piano. It's just interesting that they're organized in a similar numeric way. But anyway, so science connection. There's a jumping off point here for science where you can find out how rainbows are made, or when are they made. Here's a hint. You want to find out about light. You want to find out about moisture. You want to find out about what a storm or a harsh weather pattern has to do with making a rainbow. That's kind of an interesting thing to think about. There's a little bit of a message of hope in there as well. But Mr. Sword was talking about rainbows with me. I said, Mr. Sword, are there ways that we can incorporate art with this rainbow project, Somewhere Over the Rainbow? He said, absolutely. So this is what he recommended. And if we could zoom in on this, that'd be great. He said, you know, for K1, it would be fantastic. And again, this will be on the portal. For K1, it would be fantastic if you took this opportunity to make basic shapes in rainbow patterns. That would be a lot of fun. That would be a really, really useful thing to do, to just explore all the different ways that you can use rainbows on basic shapes, the building blocks of everything that we see. He said also, 2-3, oh, that's K1, sorry. 2-3, you can make actual objects and make them rainbow colored. So I see a rainbow umbrella, I see a rainbow parrot, a rainbow hot air balloon. There are all sorts of regular shapes that you can use to that you can color rainbow. Rainbow fish, all sorts of neat stuff, and that's great. And then he said 3-5. This is kind of an interesting thing, a little bit higher level, more of a concept thing. You know, the idea of a pot of gold being at the end of a rainbow, that's a pretty powerful idea. And he said, you know, what do you hope there to be at the end of this whole COVID situation? What is the positive outcome that you're hoping for at the end of this COVID situation, the pot of gold at the end of this? And draw a picture of that. You can send it to him, you can send it to me. That's that beautiful two-way street part of education. Education is not just about me making nice content and delivering it to you. It's about hearing back from you how it's impacting you or what you're thinking along with it. And together we learn on that journey. It's a wonderful thing. There's one thing that I did forget to do for K1 or K2. Would I have a tissue right there? Can I have a tissue? Yeah. Everyone's got tissues at home right now, I'm quite sure. Thank you. All right. And tissues are great. I would love it if K1 or K12 tried using scarves or tissues to dance and feel the flow of the music as you're listening to those wonderful recordings. Flow is a very, very important part of music and musicality, and I want to encourage you to grow in that way, even during this time where we're not connected in the normal ways. So I want you to do that. Scarves are great. Get, you know, crazy scarves, beautiful scarves. Maybe have your parents put up a video on their Facebook page or something like that. That'll be fun to see what you guys all do there. I hope you found this lesson hopeful and inspiring. And it's cool how music, once again, connects with everything around us. I feel like at this time, music matters more than ever before. It brings us hope. It reminds us of who we are. And like Branson, it should be the kind of thing where one of our antennas goes up and it sort of stops us in our tracks and helps us focus on something that's really, really important. Something that's telling us something inspirational and hopeful. I hope you guys listen to a lot of music. I hope you have fun during this time. Make the best of everything and stay safe. Wash your hands, all of that stuff. I'll be in touch with you. For now, that's it. Thank you, Mr. B, signing off.